Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be doing the third week of April's cash stuffing and unstuffing for the second week. So just had to remind myself where we are in the month. What month is it? It's been kind of a crazy whirlwind for me. But today I am not doing this right before bed super late. So I'm feeling quite energized. So let's see how the session goes. Let's get started. Okay, so first we're gonna do the unstuffing. I always have the cash here. I'm like, oh, I need to put it to the side. But today I kind of sort of planned a little bit. So we only have to put a couple things to the side. All right, let's get started with making some change. All right, so here's the $1 challenge where I make all my change. We're gonna do a couple of larger bills this time because I feel like I keep running out of change. So 10, 15, 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30. So let's do 30 for now, and we'll see if that is enough change. Okay. 10, 5, 1s. So first off, we are going to be doing, should we do the reverse? Let's do the reverse. So first off, we're gonna do my envelope. So I splurged a little bit this last week and got myself some Starbucks. I refilled my Starbucks app with $25. And I also spent some money on some skincare. So that's coming tomorrow. I think I got a couple of like facial cleansers. I did some eye cream. I think I got another like a serum for my face. So I'm trying to really streamline my skincare routine, keep it very simplified. I'm also trying to use very basic, I guess you'd say drugstore type skincare. I've done K-Beauty, which I do love, but sometimes it's just overwhelming with how many products are out there. And so right now I'm just basically doing a double cleanse, which is an oil-based cleanser if I'm wearing makeup, usually at night, followed by a water-based cleanser, which is kind of, I think, the cleanser most people would be familiar with. And then I do, I've got some retinoid that I got prescribed from my dermatologist that I'm starting. And then just a couple other moisturizers. Basically, I'm really happy with how my skin is right now. So I'll let you guys know what I think of these products. Okay, so first off, $112 is gonna come out. So 100, 10, 11, 12. Oh, that is perfect. So $112. So it was nice to build up that envelope for a little bit so I could do a splurge. The next one is, that's it. That's it for my envelopes, my binders, okay? Next up, we're gonna do the kids. So kids also has quite a bit that's coming out. $161 for kids today. And that is, let's see, what did we do? We did some snacks because we went to the park on Sunday and then we went to their little group tennis camps through the park system. And so it was really hot and my kids, this is not a good sign of summer. They were complaining about the heat already. It is April and we live in the Midwest. This is not usual weather. So I really am a little bit fearful of how they're going to handle July and August. But anyways, got some Gatorade and a little snack for them before their tennis practice. They drink all the water I brought. I brought full jugs for each of them, myself, and then I also have another like half gallon jug that I fill purely with ice and then water so that we can refill our water bottles. Went through it all. And then what else? I also spent just under $140 on basically a bunch of pairs of athletic shorts for my two older kids. So I think they got three pairs of shorts each and then also got some new pair of athletic shoes for my oldest because his were all beat and worn out. So, okay. 100, 20, 40, 61. This is perfect. Great change. And this does not include the shorts that I was planning to get through the Old Navy gift card. So what I like to do is I've come to find out because I have boys and they like to sit in the dirt, is I like to have more of like that nylon-y material, you know, like gym shorts, basketball shorts for when they're playing, especially because my kids love to play with water, so there's a lot of mud and dirt. But then I like to have more tailored, you know, chinos or kind of Dockers type, you know, shorts for when we're going to the store or going out to eat. And so those are what I like to buy at Old Navy, because they sell pretty nice quality shorts for very inexpensive, in my opinion, for kids. So that's what this gift card is going to. So yes, I need to buy more shorts, but it's kind of like they're dress shorts and I don't have to buy as many. All right. Next up, we are going to go to the sinking fund. So I'll just put the challenge, give us a little bit more space. All right, so starting from the top here, we've got gas, which is $137. So I think that's what, three tanks. 100, 20, 35, 6, and 7. Perfect. Probably didn't need to make that much change this time, which is okay. I think what, I did $30 in change, so I'll have to take $30 out. Groceries, I did a big grocery run. So my local store had this mega sale on their pub burgers, which I love to stock up on. So I think I got like 15 burgers and it was like $30 for the burgers alone, which was great. So $120 for that grocery run. Plus some other stuff, right? Of course. Milk delivery is $22. So I'm not sure why that one this week is 22, but usually it's 20, so we will get $8 back. Eating out is going to take out $51. So this one, we did Domino's pizza one night when I was just really busy and the kids were crying for pizza because they just absolutely love pizza. And then we also did a Five Guys. So when we went to the park, I said, okay, we'll buy Five Guys and then we'll eat it at the park. So first of all, I cannot believe how expensive little cheeseburgers are at Five Guys now. Where I am, it's like $9.81. So I bought a burger each for my kids and then I had the little fries for them to share and then made them drink their water bottles. So, which was perfect because my middle son doesn't finish his burger all the time. So I just kind of ate what his burger was. Raise your hand if you are a parent that finds that you have overeaten during your child rearing years because you hate to see food go to waste and you end up cleaning your kid's plate. I made the rookie mistake of serving myself food on a lot of things, like when we'd go out, and then still eating my kids' leftovers. So now I try not to order myself at least a full meal, and then I just, you know, maybe an appetizer or a side, and then I finish up the kids. It sounds kind of gross when I recount it here, but really it kind of works out. My kids are very, very light eaters. Okay, household is going to take out 135, so 100, 20, 30, and 5. Perfect again. And this is for our lawn care service. So this isn't for mowing. My husband mows our yard. He's one of the few people in our neighborhood who actually still mows his own yard. But this is for the like True Green chemicals and stuff that we put in the grass to kill the weeds and stuff. And yeah, I know it's terrible for the earth and I do feel a little bit badly about it. So anyways, my mom usually handles that. And then I'm just, this money went to pay her back for our portion of it. Car insurance is going to take out 269. So 100, 200, 50, 70. So yeah, so $1 back. So this is a big unstuffing this week. Vehicle maintenance, oh, this one is $797. This is for 4 tires. We get our tires at Discount Tire. I think it's a national chain. Basically, they have, if you pay, I think it's $65 extra and no questions asked, they replace your tire if you pop it, get a hole in it, whatever. So we do that all the time. It's 5 minutes from our house. We could actually walk there. We also did like a big oil changes on the car and I think we replaced some stuff like air filter and wiper blades. So all of those things combined, not all at the same place, but adds up to just under $800. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 750. Why am I short here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 750. Let me just double check 1 second. Something is off here. because I should have 895, and I'm not sure why. I wonder if I already took something out last week. But anyways, I'm gonna take out $700 and we'll figure out where that 97 should go. So $700. Okay. That's very strange. I will have to go back and figure out what happened. Okay, subscriptions is gonna be $8, and this is for our Google Nest. So 10, take back 2. And finally, health is going to be $188. So let's see, 150, 70, 90. So I'll get $2 back. And that really depletes health quite a bit. Okay, so that is it for the cash unstuffing. It was going to be an even $2,000 that we unstuffed, but now it's because of that $797 not being there. It is $1,903. So let me double check all of that. So first off, we're going to take out $30. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's do 10. 10, 15, 20, 25, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30. Okay, so that'll go back into $1 challenge. I'm really curious as to what happened with the car there. Okay, so now it should be 1,903. In here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 1,200, 50, 13, 50, 14, 50, 15, 50, 16, 50. So 1,650, 70, 90, 17, 10, 30, 50, 70, 90, 18, 10, 30, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 1,900, 1, 2, and 3. So $1,903 is going to go back to the bank. Look at all those 100s. And so therefore that will be used to pay off that credit card. And like I said, I'm missing $97 from the car maintenance. I'm not sure what happened. I'm wondering if I double counted an oil change, but I'll have to go look at last week's video and see. All right, so we're gonna put this off to the side and let's get our regular cash. And 1 second while I redo all of my, okay. So today we are going to be stuffing $1,279. No placeholders. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 500, 50, 600, 50, 70, 90, 710, 30, 50, 70, 90, 810, 30, 50, 70, 90, 910, 30, 50, 70, 90. 1,000, 10, 30, 50, 70, 90, 1,100, 10, 30, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 1,200, 10, 20, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 61, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 70, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So $1,279 today. So first off, we're going to go in reverse order again. We're going to do the $1 challenge. So $1 challenge is going to get $12. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So that'll make some good change next week. And I don't count this until the end of the year where I earmark it for something fun. Next up is going to be the 12-month challenge. So that is going to be $80. So we're going to go to February, April. And as you can see right here, $80 is what is for week number 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have 50, 100, 20, 40, 60, 80, 200, 10. Next up is going to be kids' birthday. Whoops, this came out. Okay. And today we are going to save $15. You have 100, 200, 50, 70, 80, 90, 300, 5, 10, 15. So we're exactly halfway through. My middle son switched schools starting in March, and he's got a class of 7 kids, including him. And I'm not even kidding when I say 4 of the kids have birthdays in basically from now through like the first week of June. So I just got put on their phone text group, and one of them was like, oh, I want to give you all the dates of stuff that's coming up. And it was like 4 birthday parties and a barbecue at one of the family's house. I guess there's like a rotating play date and everybody hosts once a month. And so the next one is at a barbecue at one of the family's houses. So it should be fun. I have not actually met any of the parents yet, so I'm going to see a lot of them in the next couple of weeks. Am I done with this? Yes. Okay, so next up is 52-week challenge. So today we are going to be stuffing $40. So unmarked envelopes, just going to put in 40, and at the end of the year, hopefully I will have a nice tidy sum and have to think about what I might spend on it. I'm kind of thinking, so I'm going to have some surgeries and stuff. And so I'm kind of thinking maybe I will put this towards maybe some clothes, because I think I'm going to need some new pants and stuff like that. So that would be exciting to maybe put it towards a little bit of a wardrobe refresh. Back to school is going to get $10. Is it? There's a 50 right here. Here's the 10. So here we go. Or if you're like me, I keep clothes from when I was a little bit smaller, and I'm always saying, oh, you know, one day I'm going to fit back into them. I can't throw them away. And that actually does sometimes work out. So I do have a couple of things that I fit into better now than I did even 6 months ago, and then will probably fit in even better, you know, after some of the surgeries. All right, so that is it for all of the challenges. We are going to go back to the top to the sinking funds. All right, so gas is going to get $100. We're still stuffing this pretty aggressively, so 121. My husband's gonna be going up to the bed and breakfast this week, so might have to do a little bit more stuffing. Groceries is also going to get $100. So 160. Milk delivery is going to get $30. So 30, 40, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Eating out will get $50. So 50, 70, 90, 110, 30, 41. Household is going to get $60. So 100, 200, 20, 40, 60, 80, 300, 20, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Vehicle insurance is going to also get $60. So 60, 80, 100, 10, 11. Vehicle maintenance is going to get $100. So 150, 1, 2, and 3. Subscriptions will get $10. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Gifts will get $50. So 150, 250, 70, 80, 1, 2, and 3. Both my husband and my oldest brother's birthdays are this month, so that's what we'll be spending that on. Nothing for holidays or timeshare or travel. Health is going to get $100. 1, 2, 3, 354, 1, 2, 3, 4. So $404. Next up is the investment binder. So let's see. Kids will be next. Kids is going to get $50. So 50, 100, counting the gift card, 10, 15, 16, 17. Allowance will get $7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. So I have 2 weeks of allowance to give to my son. Academics is going to get $25. So I am slowing this one down a little bit. 102, 3, 4, 520, 40, 5, 50, 55, 56, 7, 8, and 9. Athletics is going to get $50. So we've got 500 in the bank, 6, 7, 8, 9, 1,000, 5, 1,100, 20, 30, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Enrichment is going to get $50. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 354, 20, 35. Husband's binder. So personal is going to get $20. He's doing really well not spending any money right now. It's 20, 40, 60, 70, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Grooming is going to get nothing. Oops, didn't need to pull that out. Sartorial, though, will get 20. So 50, 70, 80, 5, 86. Business 1 is going to get $30. 20 and 30. I think someone said that I pulled money out of business 2 for business 1 or business 1 for business 2. So thank you for letting me know. I will go off camera and fix that. 50, 70, 90, 100, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Yeah, I think it's this one actually. And business 2 is supposed to have $20. Should be 50, 70, 90, 5, 6, and 7. Okay. And nothing for business 3. Finally, my binder. So for personal, gonna get $25, so 10 and 3 fives, two of which will go over into the wallet. I think I pulled in too many fives, let's see. So 100, 10, 15, 20, 25. Here we'll get $20. So $50 in gift cards, so 100, 20, 40, 55. Fashion is going to get $20. So 50, 100, 20, 40. Beauty is getting $25, so that has been completely emptied. So there's that five that I needed. And professional dues is going to get 100. So 100, 2, 3, 20, 30, 5. And that is it for my cash stuffing. I'm gonna put these two into kindness and gratitude, which I am saving up to make a donation to World Central Kitchen. In my last video, we talked about what our favorite charities were, and I was so happy to hear about some of the things that you guys are doing. That's great. I love hearing about what causes people are passionate about, especially if it highlights something that, you know, might not get a lot of publicity. Like I said, mine is World Central Kitchen. I really identify with their mission statement and the real world impact that they have, as well as the fact that, you know, I feel like they are a very responsible organization with how they use donations. So that is why I like to support that group. All right, we are at the end of our video. Let me know, Mother's Day is coming up in about a month, so let me know what some of your favorite things to gift are. So I know a lot of times we say as mothers, we want to spend time with our kids or with our own mothers, but I'm looking for different ideas that are small, like gift basket. Like if you were to give a gift basket to a new mom or a grandmother, what are some things that you would put in it? Like candles or fuzzy socks or maybe a good book. Let me know in the comments what you would like to get if you were getting something like that, or what you love to give somebody else. All right. Thank you, everybody. I will talk to you in the next video. Bye.